Welcome back to the Forms for SharePoint video guide. In the previous videos, we have explored how to design the forms, how to connect SharePoint sites, lists, and libraries with the help of list library control and lookup control. If you haven't seen those videos yet, I have linked the full playlist in the description, and don't forget to subscribe to not miss any of the future videos. Today, we're going to look at how to create and configure form sets for different Microsoft 365 and SharePoint groups, of course, with the help of Plumsail Forms for SharePoint app. So let's start. As you might know, in the group section of Microsoft 365 Admin Center, you can create and manage various groups. These groups serve as hubs for collaboration among users as they facilitate communication and teamwork both inside and outside the organization. They integrate with essential tools such as SharePoint, Microsoft Planner, and Teams. In today's video, we'll focus on creating and managing unique SharePoint forms for both Microsoft 365 and SharePoint permission groups, and we'll also set up custom routing. So how do we create separate form sets for different Microsoft 365 groups? Well, after you have finalized the grouping in the Admin Center under Active Teams and Groups tab, let's begin by opening Plumsail Forms for SharePoint app. We'll connect to the Team Support site and Tickets list. Once connected, you'll notice that in the upper right-hand corner, it says All Users. While this is a default form that all users can edit and access. However, there are times when you want to restrict certain information or maybe limit editing privileges. So let's proceed by clicking on the plus icon. This will redirect us to the Manage Form Sets page. And here you have the opportunity to create a new form set. You'll notice two tabs, one for Microsoft 365 user groups and the other for SharePoint groups. This allows you to configure access based on your selection. First, let's select and configure form sets for Microsoft 365 groups. Let's start by giving it a name, for example, Team Tech Support Form. The form set name can be anything. You can choose a name that makes it easier to find it later. In the Add User or Group field, you have the option to select a group or a user that you have previously created in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center under the Active Teams and Groups tab. Ensure that you've configured these groups or users before creating the form set, and select all groups that a user needs to be part of in order to be redirected to this form set. So I'll add the Technical Support group, click Save, and Close. And as you can see, the new form is blank. So in this case, I'll upload a pre-designed form, but of course you can design a form from scratch. Previously, I exported the form that was designed for all users, and then I added additional SharePoint fields and controls that the tech support team might need. And you can delete or add fields and controls relevant to your form set. So let's save this form set and see how it behaves in the SharePoint list. First, I'll open the form as a member of all users group. And as you can see, I only have access to a couple of fields from the list. It's enough to create a ticket request. Next, I'll add myself to the technical support group in the admin center. Once this step is complete, let's return to the list and look how the form opens for me now that I'm a part of tech support team. Let's refresh the page and click on the first item. And as you can see, a different version of the form is opened and it contains additional fields and I can also edit the form. And as I have mentioned earlier, you also have an option to create a separate form set for an individual user. So let's go back to the Forms for SharePoint app and create one more form set. Click on Manage Form Sets and this time we'll design a form set for a tech support lead. Let's call it the same. In the Add User or Group field, I'll be adding myself. I'll click Save. And you might be wondering, how will the tech support lead access the correct form if he or she is also part of the whole tech support team? Well, on the left-hand side, you can adjust the position of the form set within the list. This determines its priority for opening when conditions are met. So form sets higher on the list have higher priority. By positioning the tech support lead form above the team tech support form, the admin will open the form set designed specifically for them. However, if you change the order, the admin will open the form set designed for the whole team. This flexibility allows for precise control over which form set is accessed based on user roles and requirements. So let's save this form set. Now let's explore how to create form sets for SharePoint security groups and use standard permission groups, owners, members, and visitors. By configuring form sets for these predefined SharePoint groups, you can effectively manage access and ensure the users have appropriate permissions to interact with the forms. We are starting on a communication site called Latest News, and the list is dedicated to monthly company events. We want to set it up so members of the site can view the events, click the links included in the form, but they would not be able to make any changes or create new events. Only the site owners will have these permissions. Let's begin by opening Forms for SharePoint app and connect to the latest news site and monthly event itinerary list. Here we'll be creating a couple of different custom form sets. And as you can see, I have already designed the form for all users, so let's export it so we can reuse it later. After exporting, we'll adjust the current form to ensure that the list items can be viewed by the members but cannot be edited by them. To accomplish this, we'll mark all fields as read-only. Alternatively, in the SharePoint site permissions, you can set read-only permissions for the members. And I'll fast-forward the rest. Great, now all fields are read-only. At the top of the form, I can add a text control to provide instructions to the site members. Let's add the following text. For any inquiries or to confirm your attendance, please click RSVP. If you have any questions, please email the organizer. Make sure to include the session code in the subject of your message for swift assistance. So let's save the form and check how it opens in SharePoint. I'm viewing the list as a member of the site, and I'll refresh the page and select the charity dinner event. Great, as you can see, all the fields are viewable but cannot be edited. A user can click on the organizer's name and email them, as well as RSVP by clicking the hyperlink and adding themselves to the guest list. And now let's go back to the app and create a new form set for the site owners. Click on the plus sign next to all users and select SharePoint groups. Let's give this form set a name, Event Organizer Form. And in the open forms, if a current user belongs to the selected groups, select owners. And you can select multiple groups a user must belong to in order to be redirected. And excluding the selected groups pops up automatically. You can exclude certain groups, but please note that exclusions have higher priority. So if a user both owner and member, then they won't be able to see the form. This time we will not be doing any exclusions. So let's click save and close. Now let's go to settings and import the form we saved earlier. This time I will not mark any fields as read-only, as of course we want to make sure that site owners can modify existing events and add new ones. However, I'll add a different note at the top of the form. This one saying when creating new events, don't forget to add the following: session code and RSVP link. So let's save the form and go back to SharePoint to see how everything works. To save time in this video, I have already added myself to the site owners group in the advanced permission settings under site permissions. So let's just click on one of the events. Fantastic. As a site owner, I can modify existing events and add new ones. As you can see, creating form sets for either global Microsoft 365 or SharePoint permission groups is a straightforward and efficient process. However, what if you have more complex conditions, including not only user memberships, but also SharePoint field values, profile properties, and other extra clauses? Plumsail Forms for SharePoint has a solution for that as well. Through custom or programmatic routing, you can incorporate complex conditions into your form sets. For instance, you can check the current item's field values, user's properties such as title or department, and other information in SharePoint. Also, you have the flexibility to redirect users to other form sets or URLs. This enhances the versatility and functionality of both your forms and form sets. It's important to note that custom routing has priority over the automatic routing. And just like with creating form sets, custom routing needs to be configured for each content type. Today, we're going to go through a useful case of adding custom routing conditions to your form sets. Let's imagine a situation where the site owner, in our case, event organizer, would like to hide the RSVP link from the site members until the event is approved and location is booked. But they still want the employees to be able to see the events. First, I have added a choice type column and called it status. It contains two options, approved and waiting for approval. We will use this item status as one of the conditions for custom routing. And as you can see, both approved and waiting for approval event forms look the same for now. Next, let's go to the Forms for SharePoint app and create two additional form sets. One that will show the link if the event is approved, and the other that will hide the RSVP link if the event is still pending approval. So let's export the current form, as we can easily reuse it with a couple of modifications. And now we're going to create our first form set and call it Event Approved. We select SharePoint Groups and set it to open for members only. Click Save and Close. Now we can import the form we saved earlier. And here we don't need to make any changes, as the form already has the field for RSVP link. We just need to save this form. Next, we follow the same steps, but this time we create form set event waiting approval. And we'll set it to open for members only as well. Again, we import the saved form, but this time we delete the RSVP field, and instead we can add text control. Let's put in there, check back shortly to RSVP once the event is approved. Let's save the form. And let's go back to the event organizer form, the one we created for site owners, and add another reminder in the text box. Please mark as approved once the event is finalized. Don't forget to save this form as well. Next, under Manage Form Sets, let's select Custom Routing. And custom routing is based on JavaScript with PNP.js library and several predefined variables describing the current context. PNP.js library contains a Fluent API for working with a SharePoint REST API, allowing you to get any information from SharePoint. In the description of this video, I have linked an article from our documentation that has code examples and more details on custom routing. So I will be using the following code example from that article as well. Now we'll change user groups index from managers to our group name, latest news members. And I'll replace and match the form set IDs with the ones I have just created. The approved event and waiting for approval. The item status can be left as is because it matches the status field we added in our list. Now we can click Save and let's test how custom routing works in SharePoint. Right now I have permissions as a member of the site, so let's open the charity dinner event that is marked approved. And the RSVP link is there and it can be clicked. Next, let's open monthly networking event. It's marked as waiting for approval. And as you can see, instead of the link, we get a note that prompts us to check in back later once the event is approved. Custom routing can be tuned to a wide variety of scenarios, like redirecting users to a certain form set if users' department matches a criterion. It is also possible to check and change the form type. For example, always open edit form instead of display form if the user has permission to edit. You can find more scenarios with code samples in the article linked in the description. If you're still here, thank you for watching, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you have a question or if there's a specific feature in the Forms for SharePoint app that you'd like us to cover, please drop a comment below. There are more videos lined up in this guide series, so hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications to not miss any of them. See you soon.